to the Big Fat Anniversary Quiz. We've been doing Big Fat Quizzes for 10 years now, so we thought what better way to celebrate than with another Big Fat Quiz. This is the Big Fat Quiz's 10th birthday party, and just like my actual 10th birthday party, only 6 guests have showed up and all of them had to be paid. Channel 4 have spared no expense for our 10th birthday celebrations, so if you'll excuse me... Good. Now that's out of the way, let's meet the teams. First up, they're the answer to the question, what's the worst-case scenario, son-in-law-wise? Ladies and gentlemen, the Goth Detectives are back. It's Noel Fielding and Russell Brand. Every father's nightmare. Next up, from Star Wars, it's Warwick Davis, and from the autograph queue at the Star Wars convention, it's Jonathan Ross. And finally, she's famous for her ballroom on Strictly. He's famous for his lack of ballroom in skinny jeans. It's Claudia Winkleman and Jan Whitehall. Noel, talk me through the look.
I think it speaks for itself, really. Do you want to see it all?
Yeah, let's. Can we get a little look at Noel's incredible outfit?
It's sort of, what's it like? Andy Pandy covered in hundreds and thousands.
My nan used to have a button box. It looks like it just exploded.
Don't get dirty and talk about your nan's button box so early in the evening. For goodness sake,
I love the idea of your nan's button box. I just cover myself in Pritt stick and then just roll about in Warwick's nan's button box.
Now, Warwick, I should apologise before we even start. Yeah, we've sat next to Jonathan. He's bound to geek out on you at some stage.
Yes, he's already been discussing the Leprechaun films with me.
Warwick made 6 in the epic Leprechaun series. I don't know how many other Leprechaun fans there are in the building. You don't.
Really?
You've never. But my personal favourites would be, well, there's Leprechaun 1, of course, Leprechaun 2, Leprechaun 3. They're pretty much the same story, essentially. Leprechaun 4, it gets interesting, because Leprechaun 4 is in space.
Yes, yes.
Leprechaun 4, a leprechaun in space. Think about that for a second. Leprechaun 5, my all-time favourite, is Leprechaun in the hood.
Yeah. And that was so successful, we went back to the hood. Yeah. For the 6th one.
Leprechaun 6, back in the hood.
Yeah.
I urge you to get the box set.
Claudia, what's going on here? What's going on with your team?
This is... Well, basically, I'm babysitting. I'm a friend of Jack's mum, and I'm here just to make sure he's fine. That's my job.
I'm perfectly happy with that dynamic.
We started doing Big Fat Quiz 10 years ago this year. That's why we're doing the anniversary special. How old were you 10 years ago?
16.
Can we get a picture of you when you were 16? Is there any...
Yeah.
Were you working as a Russell Brand tribute act?
Blondes have more fun.
Blondes also get bullied a lot more. They turn up to school looking like that.
Russell, are you confident you can do this?
Do you mean participate in the quiz, Jimmy?
Yes.
I don't know why you think Noel and I have come to this event. We're here to win and solve crime. That is why we've adopted this tableau. Plus, rapport.
OK. Our first round is all about the biggest news headlines of the last decade. The smoking ban came into effect in 2007 and was a huge success. In fact, these days, the only person smoking indoors is Jonathan Ross in Speedos. The smoking ban means pubs are now far healthier environments in which to use alcohol to destroy your heart, liver and marriage. In 2011, an Icelandic volcano erupted, covering the UK in a dense layer of thick cloud, or as Scotland called it, summer. Of course, it wouldn't be a quiz without questions. You ready?
Yes.
Yes. Yep.
And for our first question, it's over to Gandalf himself, Sir Ian McKellen.
Yes. Hello, Jimmy. Now, obviously, from my experience on The Hobbit and other films, I'm no stranger to huge record-breaking audiences, he said modestly. But here's the question. What incredible event did over 1 billion people tune in to watch in 2010?
OK, so what did 1 billion people tune in to watch in 2010? It was a live event.
Jimmy?
Yes, Russell.
That was ages ago, and we can't remember.
I see what's happened there.
I was under the impression this quiz was about information that was germane to the day, topical things.
That is the regular Big Fat Quiz. This is the Big Fat Anniversary Quiz.
In that case, we need to renegotiate. These things are all ages ago. Noel and I live in the present. We're spiritual men.
I can't live in the moment. I can't remember yesterday.
Who's to say there was a yesterday? Where's the proof?
Proof.
A billion.
Where's the proof?
The proof.
Who knows how to pronounce it? Where's the proof?
Can I immediately just say that I'm going to need, I sense, some sort of erasing device?
No, because that's correct.
No, 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 this isn't correct. Blue announcing the reunion.
Well, now you've given them the answer, so... They didn't know what it was, and now they're just going to copy us.
I'm going to give you a clue for this one. The event a billion people tuned in to watch concerned...
Anthony Costa.
Duncan James.
Simon Webb. And the other one.
Oh, if you'd known them all.
Yeah, Duncan James.
Duncan James.
Lee Ryan! How did I forget Lee Ryan?
Oh, that is so terrible. Russell, Noel, it's come to my attention that you have not written anything yet.
We are not writing anything down.
Yes, you are.
You're trying to control us and we don't like it.
Russell, stop fighting the system.
We don't agree with your system of writing things down. If you can trust us...
Are you refusing to vote again, Russell?
Yeah. I won't have that. We're not participating.
how dare you, young man? Is that your special magic pen? That's your special pen that we got you special.
Sorry.
We're already controlling it. You're looking marching about like a ventriloquist doll.
I do not look like a ventriloquist doll.
Why are you so defensive?
Yes, Jimmy, come and... don't look like a doll, come and sit on my knee for a second.
You don't look anything like a doll.
Yeah, let's see how this works
I honestly
out.
Don't.
Let's see how this works out.
No, this is the thing. This is demeaning.
So what do you like to do in your time off?
I like to sit on Uncle's lap.
Do you? And what do you like about it?
Like, I like it when he takes my temperature without using his finger.
You dirty puppet.
This is all wrong. Write down an answer.
See, they can't control it when we disobey.
Yeah. This is the start of the revolution.
Hold on. This is not the start of the revolution.
Yes.
You see what happens? You start messing about and then the younger boys want to copy you.
I just said to him, do you want to find the pen? He went, I'm not a rebel like them.
You are! The Ewoks were in the Rebel Alliance.
That's true, absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah, you know what? He's a fucking actor. He isn't an Ewok, all right?
He's just shaved his face, you don't know.
A bit hairy down there.
Okay, question number two. It wouldn't be a Big Fat Quiz without the children of Mitchell Brook Primary School in Neasden. For our anniversary, they put on another one of their rather unconventional school plays. But what news story are they acting out here?
These are my ideas. Let's use this machine. Let's switch it on.
Stop. What if it blows up the world?
The end is nigh. The end is nigh.
Here we go.
When they come out, he all quietly went, good outfits.
Okay, so what news story were they acting out there? Russell, Noel?
Yes?
You know when you said you weren't going to write anything?
That's right.
Please write something.
We won't. Furthermore, if this quiz is not a fix, how come we've been doing it 10 years and them children still ain't grown up? You must have been with stupid. You must think we're absolute idiots. Yeah. What quiz? What con? What fix?
Okay, have a look at this picture. What's happening here?
I'll help you.
Okay, so what's going on there?
Was it? I didn't even.
I think we might have it.
Yep.
So what event? Yeah. Next up, it's over to the undisputed king and queen of baking. It's Paul Hollywood and Mary Berry.
Hi, Jimmy. No one in the world knows more about cake than us.
But in 2013, an old stale piece of cake sold at an auction in the US for $4,000. What made this piece of cake so special?
Duncan James made it.
How old was that bit of cake, did they say?
They didn't say, but I'm willing to tell you. I'll tell you that. It was, it was in 2011.
What, 2011? I know the answer.
What happened in 2011?
Cake was made in 2011.
Yes, cake was made in 2011.
2011.
And finally, have a look at this clip of a Spanish lady on the defensive. What has she done?
El cura lo sabía, el cura lo sabía. El sacerdote de aquí lo sabía. Claro, ¿cómo lo voy a hacer yo sin que me lo diga? Sí.
The key to that is her shabby air.
Yes.
If we know what her shabby air is, we'll know the answer.
You're right.
Do you know what her shabby air is?
I don't. I've not seen it.
I've got it! I've got it! Yes!
She's back. Good boy.
And you can't...
Deal
what have
it.
I done?
Because you're going to throw all your facts at me, but you can't prove this one wrong, puppet man.
Ross was looking into the middle distance. What's happened?
We're having fun.
Jimmy, or may I call you Puppetto? if you wish to encourage the young men on my right to take part in the quiz, yep. I suggest you offer them something in the way of a prize. Perhaps, for example, a puppet they could take home and cherish and play with.
Are you suggesting I prostitute myself in order to elicit five
no,
answers?
No, no, it doesn't have to be prostitution in the little sense. It could just be that they actually get to hang out with you a little while.
No, 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 I want a blowy off the puppet.
No, maybe that's the noise he makes as he finishes.
OK, let's get some answers. Should we get some answers?
Yes, let's get some answers.
First up, Sir Ian McKellen asked you which live event was watched by over a billion people. What did you put?
Chilli Miners, but we put a pattern.
Oh, they've shut my pen off, the bastards.
That is the system!
Jonathan Warwick, did you get that?
We first of all, we were going with the Royal Wedding, but then we thought Chilli Miners as well.
Wow.
Well, we put that.
What did you put?
Well, we put the blue thing or the Miners coming up, but then maybe they're linked.
Well, it was the
Maybe that's why the Miners wanted to come up.
Yeah, this was 33 men trapped underground for 69 days.
Wow.
Points all round there. OK, marvellous. All right. We saw the children of Mitchellbrook Primary School performing a play. Did you know what it was?
Yeah, we know what that is.
OK, what was it?
It's to do with that collider thing, that thing that's colliding subatomic particles to prove that the physical dimension that we live in ain't even real or nothing. It's a hydroparticle collider thing, right?
What he said.
No one is wearing the result of that experiment.
I think you kind of get a point for that. There's a lot of the right words were in there.
Yeah.
Jonathan, Warwick, did you get this?
Warwick wanted to go with Star Wars, but I think he just likes talking about Star Wars. But we went with Hadron Collider.
OK. What did you put for this? Do you get it?
Yes.
You all got that as well. It was the discovery of the Higgs boson particle with a large Hadron Collider.
Yes.
Yeah.
OK. I showed you this still. Did anyone remember what was going on?
We know about this.
Go on.
There was some rioting, and then immediately afterwards, Squares ruined the vibe by sweeping up.
Jack.
I thought it was the Hogwarts graduation. it was a wonderful day. We all had a jolly good time. There I am in the middle.
Jonathan, did you get this?
We put riots, just generically riots.
Right, the day after the riots, loads of people came out and they swept up. It's inspiring stuff.
They did target the wrong shops, didn't they? Because they kept me in for Tesco's Metros and stuff like that. But the advantage of looting is there's no budgetary restrictions, so just go... Well, it would have been great to see more rude boys with Waitrose premium products just walking around the street. Bad man got a John Dory.
Bad man got a John Dory.
Yes, because he's stolen a nice fish from the deli counter.
It was the clean up after the riots.
Yep.
Okay. Paul Hollywood and Mary Berry asked you why a stale piece of cake went for over $4,000 at auction. What did you put?
Was it the Queen's cake?
You're very close, but you didn't get the right answer on this one. Jonathan Warwick, did you get it?
We put it was the royal wedding cake, and we're going to win the puppet.
Claudia Chang, do you get it?
We used this opportunity to partake in some playground ribbing by suggesting that the £4,000 cake was bought by Jonathan because he was hungry.
I have I've never met a cake I didn't like, it has to be said.
Have you done, though, a full cake on your own, a full, like, birthday cake on your own?
I bought a child's X-Men cake and ate it all on my own in my pants whilst crying on the saddest day of my life.
And Blue split up?
Correct. The darkest day in our history.
Have you ever had a whole Viennetta?
Have I ever had a whole Viennetta? I've never had a Viennetta.
What are you talking about?
What? That's why you're not happy. The Viennetta is the best dessert ever, because if you looked at it and you were saying, how much does that cost, I would say, like, at least £30.
At least.
And it's only, like, £1.50. It's ridiculous. It's so underpriced. It is a marvel of architecture.
OK, so, Jonathan, you get a point there for the royal wedding cake.
Thank you, Jimmy.
And finally, I asked you what the Spanish lady had done. Did anyone get this?
Yes.
Noel, Russell? Mm.
Jack did.
Did you know?
Is she or you lot?
I'm over here, Russell.
Someone must know.
No.
What is it?
Oh, no, Russell's wandering around.
What is that Spanish lady? She painted Jesus. That is the answer. She painted Jesus.
Where's Button Boy gone?
Just gave Russell a haircut.
Stay there, my boy.
I like.
See, some people, when they sit on a lap, don't automatically look like a puppet. What did Geppetto do to you? What is that woman want about Spain? Tell us.
I don't know, maybe...
Get another one.
OK, so what did the Spanish lady... What was she apologising for? What had she done?
Well, I thought she was Banksy.
And
tell me that she isn't.
You can't...
Because you can't prove that she isn't, and I think she's Banksy.
OK, Jonathan, Warwick.
Well, I think that she tried to improve a painting, sort of restore a painting, and messed it up.
There was a fresco of Jesus in some church that was falling in disrepair, and she... It was quite a sweet thing she did, really.
I fucking said that!
Jonathan, no, you didn't!
I said it over there!
Someone else said it over there! That isn't the same as you saying it.
I don't think you understand communism.
Well, I can tell you that is the right answer, Jonathan Warren.
Yeah.
Do you want to have a look at the painting? This is the painting before.
Yes.
That's the painting, which is quite a beautiful old fresco. Here it is after.
I think ours is better.
Done. Okay. So that's the end of the first round. Let's check in on the scores. Russell and Noel, despite writing nothing down and doing a pattern, have got 3 points.
Wow. Good work. Don't need this.
Which is one more than Jack and Claudia, who were trying their best. Jonathan and Warwick are in the lead with 5.
Come on, give it. Boom,
boom. Okay, we're going to take a short break. See you in a bit. Welcome back to the Big Fat Anniversary Quiz. This round is about the last 10 years of TV. TV box sets of American dramas became all the rage. I can't tell you how many hours I spent watching the first season of 24. The Wire was a massive hit and instantly became the number one show people pretended to love whilst really watching X Factor. Deal or No Deal started in 2005. Deal or No Deal is the show which has 23 boxes and just one question. What else is on? The show originated in Holland and remains the best thing to come from there, which you don't have to smuggle out up your ass. Let's remind ourselves of what we've been watching over the last 10 years.
Let's fire up the quattro.
Hello!
Stomach is sick, and it's all in my head. But
coffee.
What? No, no, no! Classic. Okay, everyone, some TV questions. Survivalist Bear Grylls taught us how to cope in a whole range of situations we're unlikely to face. But as a last resort, what unconventional method did he use to stay hydrated at sea?
Nah. I'm in charge of this now.
Okay. Something rank, wasn't it?
Okay.
Filthy little devil.
Noel, Russell, Noel, if you write down the answer, Russell, if you could just send a text. Marks and Spencer's launched a series of sexy adverts described as food porn. Can you tell me what the tagline at the end of every ad was?
Yeah.
Good.
Well, Russell's had a text.
What? No, I ain't. F off.
Did you get someone's number when you went into the audience?
I may have released a few spores.
OK, and for our next question, it's over to my favourite ever X Factor veteran. It's Chico.
Oh. Hello, Jimmy. It's Chico here. Well, guess what time it is? It's time for my question, of course. Now, I lost the X Factor to Shane Ward in 2005, but I'm in good company. Susan Boyle lost Britain's Got Talent in 2009, and One Direction lost the X Factor the following year. Can your teams tell me the act who beat them?
Chico is wearing a Dairy Lee around his neck.
Can I just say, although we love Chico, I partook in a show that he was also on some years ago, and afterwards we swapped numbers. I texted him and he never texted me back. I got snobbed by Chico.
So Chico wants to know who beat One Direction on X Factor and who beat Subo in Britain's Got Talent.
Well, know. One Direction, I don't know. Susan Boyle.
Oh!
Her inner demons.
Come on.
No, are you doing a picture or done some answers?
What?
What?
Are you doing
what did you say, Puppet Man? Puppet Man, help me!
I don't know what's happening. I don't know what he's doing. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know where I am or who you are.
As I've got nothing to lose, I am just going to text Chico now. I haven't texted him for 5 years. Russell, should I put one kiss or two?
I would say for Chico, this is a two-kiss situation, one big, one small.
OK. We'll just send that. Who beat One Direction on X Factor? Who beat Susan Boyle on BGT? Let's see if Chico replies. You better, otherwise I will harm myself.
Next up, have a look at these reaction videos that were uploaded to YouTube. Which TV event are these people reacting to?
Oh, no! Oh, shit! Oh! Oh, really?
Oh, my God! Oh, my God, that's just... Oh, my God, I can't even deal with it right now.
No, 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 no!
They're watching telly.
Yeah, they're watching a TV show, and what were they reacting to? It's an episode of a TV show.
This is really weird. It is like when you've texted a girl, I'm just waiting for the three dots. nothing yet. Well, shall I send another one or not?
No!
No, don't call him. I don't want to look too eager. We'll let it rest for a bit. But if he hasn't texted me back in 5 minutes, I'm sending another one, just with like a kiss or something, just to say, hey, I'm here.
Good plan. Like, cool. And finally, Doctor Who came back in 2005, but in a recent poll, who was voted the show's greatest villain? Greatest ever Doctor Who villain.
Maybe it's one of... Sorry, who was voted the greatest ever Doctor Who villain?
Do you find Siri sexy?
I like being told what to do in that way.
Yeah. I like the 1-2-1 lady. And I was very drunk once, and I woke up the following morning, and I had tried to have sex with the 1-2-1 lady. You know the text message that says, you have two new voicemails, call this number. I'd replied to it saying, are you still up? So drunk, I tried to fuck voicemail.
Awesome. I love him a little bit.
And then, like, five messages to Chico. Where are you?
I mean, I don't want to sound like an exam invigilator, but some of you put your phones away.
If he's allowed to text Chico, I'm texting Darius to ask him the answer.
That is fair, to be honest.
Yeah. Can I just tell you, I have a story about Darius. He once said goodbye with a 7-section
shotgun salute.
Wow. So you said goodbye, Darius.
Goodbye, Darius. Thanks for coming on. Where am I?
And he went to you.
Okay, let's get some answers. All right, I asked you how Bear Grylls stayed hydrated at sea. What did you put?
He wrote a poem. It was so sad, he cried and collected the tears.
That's our answer, as you can see from the portrait.
He's not even a bear, either. It's pathetic.
And why don't you ever grill nothing? The whole thing's a farce.
Jack, Claudia, what did you, how did you think Bear Grylls kept himself hydrated?
Drank his pee.
Yeah, but then I thought it would be... It's always something ranker, because he just wants the shock factor, so I put drinking from a whale's dick. Because it's always... No, it's always gratuitous and horrible.
Okay, Jonathan, Warwick, what do you think?
Warwick seemed to know this.
I did. Enema selfie.
Yeah.
See, well, let's have a look, shall we?
Oh. I've collected some fresh water, but it's full of bird droppings and it's rancid. Drink this and you'd probably vomit and risk worsening dehydration. But there is a way of using it to gain life-giving fluids, but only as a last resort. I'm going to give myself an enema.
I'm not expecting this to be particularly pleasant.
By performing an enema, you bypass the gag reflex, rehydrating your body without the risk of vomiting.
And then once it's in... Oh, I guess all you can do is lie back and think of England!
He is a dirty bastard. And can you imagine, if that was filled with bird shit going up, when it came back out, imagine the state of that water, and he probably kept reusing it, when all he had to do was say to the cameraman, can I share some of your water?
I asked you what the M&S tagline was for their sexy adverts. What have you got, Jonathan?
It was all sexy shots of food, and didn't the voice say then, do you want to eat it or fuck it? Wasn't that the tagline?
Jack, Claudia, do you remember this?
I can't... It was something like, this is not ordinary food. This is M&S food.
You sound like a 12-year-old posh boy trying to get in to see an 18 film.
I've been to many 18s. You trying to get into the cinema.
Oh, yeah, I'm a film critic. Can I review it?
Why not walking like...
That's how you talk.
Do you never watch yourself on TV? You do that all the time.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mickey Rourke.
You do?
Do I do that one?
No.
Well,
I... Too, Brutus.
OK, shall we all listen? Let's have a little look at one of the M&S ads. This isn't at all sexually explicit.
Exclusive, traditionally aged, Root Prestige Carver. And a bottle is yours, absolutely free, when you spend over £35 on food or drink at M&S until Saturday. This is not just food. This is M&S food. Mm.
Do you want to eat it or fuck it? Was the actual final line.
OK, Chico asked you who beat One Direction and Susan Boyle. Did anyone remember this?
Yes.
Noel and I don't know about things like that. We're really...
Was it Matthew? Someone called Matthew.
Was it someone called Matthew? What? Weirdly, yeah.
Was it?
Yeah. Matt.
Have you just channeled that?
That's come through.
That was a guess.
OK.
I was getting Matthew. That's weird, isn't it?
OK, Jack, Claudia, who did you think?
We thought it was Diversity and JLS.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you're very close. Jonathan, Warwick?
Diversity and Matt Curdle.
You can have that. It's Curdle, but yeah.
Can I get a point for Matthew?
I think you should get half a
point. Especially as it came from another dimension.
I know.
Jimmy, do you know what time it is? Eating Viennetta and crying time.
Is Chico not called?
Nothing.
Shall I text him now and see if he texts
me
back?
Have you got Chico's
well?
Number?
Have I what?
Have you got Chico's number?
No.
Have you got anyone's number?
No. I've got one number in my phone, it's mine. I call myself occasionally.
Well, you got it right there, Jonathan Warwick.
Yes.
Subo was beaten by Diversity and One Direction lost out to Matt Cardle. Yeah, unlucky One Direction. Where are you now? OK, we saw a bunch of reaction videos taken from YouTube. What were the viewers reacting to?
MasterChef.
You thought it might be MasterChef?
Yeah.
The woman going, oh!
Surely the people here are responding to the internet phenomena, two girls and one cup.
No. Jonathan Warwick?
The correct answer is the Red Wedding from Game of Thrones.
What?
That is the right answer.
Yes.
Yes. Good work.
Booyah.
Spoiler alert, it doesn't go well. I asked you who topped the poll of greatest Doctor Who villains.
Yes.
What did you get?
The Daleks.
So you've gone with Daleks. What have you gone for, Jack and Claudia? It was, of course, the Daleks. The Weeping Angels came second and the Master came third. Noel, talk us through your picture.
That's Subo. Well, I wasn't really thinking about it. It just came out.
Okay, time for a quick bonus round. I've significantly improved pictures from three films from the last 10 years. Can you tell me what they are? So here's the first one. Okay, there I am. Nothing the matter with that.
Wow.
Next one, there I am.
That is brilliant.
Final one.
Wow.
Oh, yeah, you might need some quiet time with that one.
Wow. That is quite something. Diana?
Yeah, that's the haircut. I'm considering that haircut. Okay, let's have a look at the answers. Russell, Noel, what have you got?
Juno.
Yeah.
Iron Lady.
Yeah.
Twilight.
Three for three. He's three for three. Okay, so 3 points for everyone. This is what's so frustrating with you two when you try. You're so gifted that you won't stop messing around.
It was our upbringing what went wrong, so we don't know what to do.
Shall we have a quick look? Let's have a quick look at how those photos were improved. There's Juno. Oh, yeah, okay. There's Twilight. And the Iron Lady.
I hated it. Nothing like Iron Man.
I was promised Iron Lady.
Her heart was normal, she couldn't fly.
Bullshit.
Right, of course. Okay, let's take a look at what that's done to the scores. Russell and Noel have 6 points. Jonathan and Warwick have 12 points. Jack and Claudia have 7 points. Time for another quick break. See you in three. Welcome back to the Big Fat Anniversary Quiz. This round's all about the best music of the last 10 years. James Blunt's You're Beautiful was everywhere in the summer of 2005. A bit like Dog Shit and Wasps.
No! No! Back the fuck off, Blunters! I'm serious, Jimmy Carr! You make jokes about the expense of chili and mayonnaise, that is fine, but you bring Blunters into the equation, you have crossed the line, my friend.
I had no idea you were so... Well, I'm worried about this one now.
If this is about Blunt again, I will walk.
As an officer in the British Army, Blunt served in Kosovo and witnessed atrocities on a par with his second album.
Oh. What is your beef with Blunters? Seriously. Come on, you're not thinking these through.
Blunters.
You hear these, yes.
Blunters.
He's a wonderful singer and he served in the army. He's a hero.
One Direction's first single, What Makes You Beautiful, was released on September the 11th and remains the worst thing ever to have happened on that date. You all right with that? You're going to kick off?
Yeah, it was funny enough for it to be OK. But it was on the edge. It was on the edge.
Yeah.
You can take... carry on.
First up, it's over to the Channel 4 newsroom, where Jon Snow is reporting on one of the biggest hits of the last 10 years. But what is it? Over to you, Jon.
An American court has ordered that a couple is to live separately after the fire services were called to their house to tackle blazes more than 3 times a week. According to doctors, the pair suffered from a rare medical condition that caused their genitals to self-combust. Victims of the condition, which is exacerbated by vigorous lovemaking, say symptoms include being hot as a fever, rattling bones, and that it feels like you're dying. You're dying. The couple were unavailable for comment as they were consumed with what's to transpire. But in a statement released earlier, they insisted, "We're still the greatest. The greatest. The greatest."
That's so disturbing, isn't it?
I assumed any answer about music I was going to write 1 to 5 was Gangnam Style.
I'm really only good on Blue Chica or James Blunt.
OK, have a look at this clip from 1969. It became the unlikely inspiration for which massive global dance craze in 2008. OK, so what dance craze did that kick off?
Don't you love those outfits? The sort of polyester two-piece suits.
What happened?
Nothing.
What happened?
You did a quiz, Jimmy.
What happened?
Sure, Noel and I have made mistakes in the past, but now we're just trying our best to be in a quiz.
Leave us alone, you bully.
OK, question three. One of the biggest hits of the decade was What Does the Fox Say by Norwegian duo Hjelvis. So my question is simple. What does the fox say?
OK.
Do you know this one?
I'm with
you.
I can hear it in my head.
OK, what is it? Whistle to me.
there's a few that I would accept. There's three or four that I would accept.
OK.
Did you genuinely not like Back to Bedlam?
The album Back to Bedlam by James Blunt?
Yeah.
You that you just Googled?
You...
So, in 2004, which notoriously raunchy dance video prompted the then Prime Minister Tony Blair to say, the first time it came on, I nearly fell off my rowing machine. I'll give you a clue. I'll give you a clue.
Go on.
Okay, he was working out when he nearly fell off the rowing machine. The video, working out, I think, is.
Oh, cool. What's the one Blue did with Elton John?
Oh, sorry, it's the hardest one.
Stick it down. Pretty sexy. Oh, Elton. Anthony Costa reclining on a piano. Yes, please.
Lee Ryan.
Russell.
Yeah, yeah.
When we have the revolution, what's happening to Old Tone?
I don't think he looks good for Old Tone.
No.
In a post-revolutionary world. Well, I mean, I find it hard to contextualise him as being on a rowing boat, being shocked by a video.
He wasn't on a rowing boat, he was on a rowing machine. I don't think you have TV on your rowing boat.
I don't know. Do they? Can we trust them? They lied about them weapons of mass destruction. Do they?
And finally, it was the decade of mobilised fandom. One Direction fans call themselves Directioners. Justin Bieber fans are referred to as Beliebers. But what are Lady Gaga fans called? Ooh. I was going to ask what a James Blunt fans called.
Oh, we know
called.
This.
Yes.
Are you on Twitter now with people?
Ah, oh, this is like a police state, man.
It's more like a police state. What did he text?
Man, this is huge.
What did he say?
Look!
Is he on there? What did he say?
His book, Hey, Jack Attack.
Oh, OMG.
Jack Attack, the answer is diversity and Matt Cardle, smiley face.
Huge. Wow. The noise you made when that came in, I genuinely thought you'd hurt yourself.
What are you going to reply to immediately?
That's like 2 years in the making. What, so I can't text back immediately because I look too keen. Yeah, leave it. If Chico calls me Jack Attack, what should my nickname be for him?
Chicotito?
Cheeky Weeky.
Snuggles?
Any ideas from the audience? Do you want to turn anything in?
Chicotito, I like.
Cheeky Tits.
Cheeky tits.
A man that hasn't texted me for 2 years. Hey, cheeky tits.
ask him out. Like, just
don't ask him out.
Get him to come here before the end of the show.
Come on, we're going to be here a while.
What should I say? Hey, cheeky tits, we're at London Studios. Come down, we need your help.
Yeah.
See you soon. Kiss. Send.
I'm done. I asked you... Have you all got that? Are you ready for the answers?
Yes.
OK, yep. All right. Jon Snow was reporting on one of the biggest hits of the last 10 years. What do you think it was?
Oh, yeah, we know that.
What is it?
It's The Kings of Leon, This Sex Is On Fire.
That's the right answer.
Yes. That's a much better answer.
And, Claudia, what did you put?
We got confused. When you said fire, I was like, fire, hot. So we put in It's Getting Hot In Here by somebody called Nelly.
Tune.
Warwick, what have you got?
We were torn. First of all, we went with Crazy Frog, and then because you kept banging on about sex and fire, we went with Sex Is On Fire.
Okay, Sex On Fire, we can give you that. Yeah, why not? Okay, we had a look at some lovely dancing from 1969. Which dance craze did it inspire? Claudia.
Beyonce, Single Ladies.
OK, I mean, it's too easy. Jonathan, Warwick, do you got it?
Yeah.
Russell, Noel. what have you put for this one?
Well, this one, the second one, that's wedding ring. Is it?
Put a ring on it.
If you like it, then you should put a ring on it. Oh! It's almost like you just... Sorry, are you texting them clues rather than the answers? If you're going to cheat, just cheat.
We're not cheating. We're participating in a quiz, and the answer, as we said quite loudly in the tape, will demonstrate, put a ring on it, wasn't it?
OK, let's take a look.
The polyester version. Mm.
There was also a movie in there that was very close to the Jonathan.
Wedding ring, wedding ring.
I think points all round there. Yeah, okay. I asked what the fox said. What did you think, Claudia? You're the expert here.
Ding 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 ding. And then later on, the song goes yucky 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 oh. That is.
What did you get, Jonathan?
I thought it was chof, 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 chof. But
I thought it was ning, 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 ning.
Yeah, that's better.
That's the crazy frog.
That's the crazy frog. I miss the crazy frog every day.
Why don't you text him?
So, Russell and Noel, you didn't answer.
Oh, well, as a matter of fact, we've got something rather better than that.
Yeah.
It's a big
if Russell opens his hand and a fly... is released into the studio. Can we have 10 points, please?
That would be fair.
Can I say I'd be happy with that?
Yeah.
We're happy with that.
Okay, everyone's happy with that. Okay, so if this is only if it flies away.
Points.
If it flies away, yeah. Here we go. Here we go.
We're transfixed. We're approaching, and now the miracle can occur. Fly. 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 How did it get here?
OK.
Please,
you can have 1 point for that.
Oh,
yeah,
you fuck off!
I'm very generous to give you anything for that.
Jimmy, we spent 6 months training that fly.
You can have a point and we're moving on. Come on, everyone.
That was Jeff Goldblum. We spent ages.
It's very hard to get him to reprise that role.
OK, so points all round for that.
Oh, dear.
OK, I asked you which music video prompted Tony Blair to say the first time it came on, I nearly fell off my rowing machine. Did you get this?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, we didn't, because we were too busy looking...
Training a fly!
Training a fly!
Which turned out to be worthless.
It's Blue and Elton John.
It was not Blue and Elton John. It was not Jonathan Warwick.
We're sticking with Crazy Frog. Mm. It's still a very sexy video.
OK, well, let's have a look. That was Eric Prydz and Call On Me. It's a weird music video, because you sort of forget there's music even playing, don't you?
This guy is just the coolest man on the bloody planet. You ready for this? Oh, man. You know I got all the chica time in the world for you. But the missus is demanding her wicked ways with me, so I got to give her a bit of chico time. Next time, my friend. Next time. Winky face. What a guy!
What a guy. Okay, I asked you what Lady Gaga's fans are called. What did you put?
Hey, they're little monsters.
Oh. They're little monsters. Okay, what do you think, Noel? Russell? Oh,
yeah, I put little bleeders. That's monsters, isn't it?
You've just slightly cockneyed it up. I can see how that would happen.
Little bleeders. Oh, I got distracted by that fucking fly.
I can tell you the answer is little monsters. Mm.
Well, we got it then.
Let's see how everyone's doing at this stage. So, Russell and Noel have 9 points, incredibly.
All right.
Jonathan and Warwick are in the lead with 16. Jack and Claudia have 10 points.
Yeah.
That's the end of the music round. If you're making a cup of tea, feel free to drop it like it's hot. See you shortly. Welcome back to the Big Fat Anniversary Quiz. This round is all about the internet. Online grocery deliveries absolutely revolutionised the way we waited in for food to be delivered that had been substituted for the food we actually ordered. Chat Roulette was the must-visit website of 2009. Huh. The great thing about Chat Roulette was it was unpredictable. There was no way of knowing what you'd see when you logged on. Maybe a big cock or a small penis. Maybe an erect willy or a flaccid knob. Hairy balls or a shaved scrotum. It was totally random. Ready for some more questions?
Yes.
Yeah. Of course you are. OK. All right, first up, have a look at this picture of Gary Brolsma, who in 2004 became one of the internet's very first viral superstars. Can you remember why?
It looks like his head would be the same if you turned it upside down.
You did. Yeah.
Put the glasses on the mouth.
Yeah, he's... That's weird. OK. Justin Bieber's baby has the honour of being the most disliked video of all time on YouTube. But what is the second most disliked video?
Right, can I just warn both of you, if anyone puts anything blunt-related, there's going to be some serious beef.
I believe okay. What the question was.
So, second most disliked video.
There's a lot of cheating going on over there, isn't there?
Cheats never prosper, don't panic. In 2008, Australian teenager Corey Worthington became an overnight star thanks to his use of MySpace, but what did he do?
MySpace?
You remember MySpace? It was like it was like an updated Bebo.
Crashed.
What?
Bebo.
And for our next question, it's over to MasterChef Supremo Greg Wallace.
Oh, Greg!
Hi, Jimmy. Now, since 2006, the whole world has been obsessed with Twitter. Even politicians got in on the act. But in 2011, what infamous tweet did Ed Balls, the Shadow Chancellor, send out that has since been retweeted 25,000 times?
It was accidental, I think.
Ed Balls? Russell, after the revolution?
I think it's going to be a tough time for Ed Balls. I shook his hand once, all clicky wrist. He was a snidey.
Why didn't you say that in the Paxman interview?
All clicky wrist sounds like something from A Clockwork Orange. It's beautiful.
All clicky wristy were a real horror show. Me and my droogies done him in. Did he good it did as he spilt his claret like silvery wine.
It sounds wonderful, but I'm going to have it Google translated to posh.
OK. Finally, one of our Say What You See puzzles. I'll give you an example. Here we go. Russell Brand. You see what we've done there?
Oh.
So these pictures spell out an online game played by more than 7 million people. Can you tell me what it is?
Do it.
Outsourced. Is that Bear Grylls giving himself another enema on the end?
We all remember playing that.
Of course we did.
OK, you ready for some answers?
Yes.
Oh, OK. Yes. I asked you what Gary Brolsma did to become one of the first viral video superstars. Did anyone remember?
No. Yeah, we did.
What do you got?
Correct answer. Marky dance, singing and miming at his desk. He done.
OK, what did you put, Jonathan Warwick?
It was a Numa 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 guy. He mimed to Numa Numa Numa.
Jack, Claudia?
Well, you just said the internet. So we went, we thought he was the first guy to complete solitaire. Because look how happy his face is. That is the face of a man that's just seen the cards fill the screen.
Well, let's take a look.
That's beautiful. Wonderful.
So Jonathan and Warwick and Russell and Noel both get points.
Yes.
Good.
Okay, I asked you for the second most disliked video of all time on YouTube. What did you put? Jonathan Warwick?
Right, I expected it from you, but you should know better.
Anything by Blunty.
It was not. Jack, Claudia, what did you get?
Justin Bieber.
So remember the question, I said Justin Bieber was the most disliked video.
Yes,
what was the second
but
most?
What was the first most hated one?
It was Baby.
Yes, and we thought the second one was Justin Bieber Boyfriend, which is a different song, Jimmy.
You got specific.
Jesus. You do know how music works. Clearly not, having hammered blunt at the beginning of this round.
All right, it's just you put Justin Bieber Boyfriend. I thought that was just a... No, what did you put?
Shall I answer it for you? Noel has requested that I answer this particular one. It's Friday, Rebecca Black is the correct answer.
Wow. Noel, do you concur?
Do you know what's under here? A quiz similar to the one that's going on now, but slightly better.
That is a hell of a thing. Is that, I mean...
Oh, my God.
look at Russell's chest there. He's still trying to carry that off as sexy.
Never yield the sex appeal, Jim, never. There's always opportunities. There's always flies to be caught. People are always looking for justice. Never yield it.
Well, you've got the answer absolutely right. Let's take a look at Rebecca Black.
That's the point. Friday, Friday, getting down on Friday. Everybody's looking forward to the weekend. Partying, 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 partying. Fun, 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 fun. Looking forward to the weekend.
Oh, bless her. I asked you how Corey Worthington used MySpace to make him an overnight star in 2008. Do you get it?
Yeah, we knew that.
What is it?
He threw a big party at his house, and then when he was asked to be contrite on Australian national news, to be like, oh, I'll never do this again, he was even more laissez-faire and blasé. He's a plucky, heroic young man, and I admire him, and any quiz that he comes as an answer in, I'm happy to be a participant in that quiz. That's just how much I know about the guy.
Jonathan Warren, you got this?
We thought he threw a party, too many people came, which is now the Facebook thing, but who knew 500 people were still using MySpace?
Yeah. Jack, Claudia?
Yes.
Soiree.
A soiree. Yes, he held a soiree and he announced it on MySpace and too many people came to said cheese and wine.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at him the day after on the news.
Did your parents say you could have a party?
No.
So, why did you?
I don't know, it was just a get-together with a couple mates at first and then we thought we might as well just have a bit of a party and then it sort of just got out of hand and, yeah.
Take a few glasses and apologise to us.
I'll say sorry, but I'm not taking off my glasses.
OK, Corey, we've got to wrap this up, but what would you say to other kids who were thinking of partying when their parents are out of town?
Get me to do it for you.
Get you to do it for you. Not don't do it.
Nah, get me to do it for you. Best party ever so far. That's what everyone's been saying.
He's great. He's good.
Why did she want him to apologise? Is she like his next door neighbour or something? Why did she?
How many people turned up?
I think 500 people turned up to his quite a small house party.
An Uber soiree.
Okay, Greg Wallace asked you what Ed Balls tweeted. What did you put?
We put hate is gonna hate # chance Lola of the Exchequer.
Haters gonna hate.
Yeah.
Or
I
thought that he famously tweeted just his name.
Okay, Jonathan, what have you got?
We thought he was another one of the victims of that serial befriender, Chico. And his desperate plea was, where are you, Chico?
Where's Chico? It's time already. That's not the right answer. Noel Russell?
Well, we've put Ed Balls and then we've parenthesised his name in brackets, isn't it, Noel?
Yeah.
Well, I can tell you, that is the right answer.
That's right.
He tweeted his own name.
What?
Ed Balls.
What a prick, that clicky wrist prick.
OK, did you get the same that you see?
Yes.
Definitely. Yes!
Yes. Take it away.
Happy.
Take it away, okay. Cards.
What you got, Claudia?
Swirl Dove Lady Raft.
Swirl Dove Lady Raft.
Yeah!
Points, please.
Russell and Noel, you've got
World of Hovercraft.
Warcraft.
Warcraft. World of Warcraft.
Jonathan, Warwick, do you
yes,
get
war. Yeah. Got it? World of Warcraft.
I enjoyed that round.
World of Warcraft. Yeah. Okay, so points to Russell and Noel, points to Jonathan and Warwick on that one.
Maximum points for us, I think, you'll find.
Yeah, you've done very well.
Do we get extra for getting the maximum?
Only if you can pull a butterfly out of your foreskin.
It's only a matter of time.
Get a point for that.
What about
you
that?
You should get a point for Button Man.
I'm going to wear this when you give me that blowy.
Ah,
there. See, we've all come with hairdressers.
Oh,
can we have a point? Oh, that actually had a really mayonnaise-y sandwich inside. Sorry. Yeah, that's mayonnaise.
Okay. Good for the hair, apparently.
Now it's time for the part of the show where I introduce my mystery guest. Now, this person has made the news at some point in the last 10 years. All you have to do is work out who they are and how they made the news. You can ask them questions, but they can only answer yes or no. Please welcome my mystery guest! Yeah! Right, sir, how are you? Very good, thank you. Nice to have you here. OK. So, panel, you can ask him anything. He can only answer yes or no.
OK.
Are you an acrobat of some nature?
No.
Are you just going on the black top and black trousers?
Did something happen to you of note over the last 10 years?
Yes. You know, this is the internet round. That's the other thing.
Did you invent Minesweeper?
No.
Does the thing you do, is it downloadable?
That was part of it, yes.
Yes. Wow.
Partly
it was downloadable.
Are you in charge of Ocado?
No, he's not in charge of Ocado.
I was getting excited there as well.
How middle class is this team?
That would have been a start innovation
time. Involved in politics of the revolutionary sort.
He was involved in a type of revolution.
Revolutionary in a way.
Oh!
Write down your answer.
Oh, my God!
Write down your answer.
The machine. Ah, that is.
Write down. We'll need to be quite specific in your answers.
This guy.
That's.
There you go. Bingo.
Okay, have you all got something?
Yeah.
What have you got, Jack? Claudia?
Rage against the machine.
Rage against the machine.
Yes.
Jonathan, Warwick?
You got Rage Against the Machine to number one, F.U. Cowell.
Russell?
We've done that.
Yeah. It was good, commendable in its sentiment, but why could it have not been your beautiful? My only sticking point.
Okay,
with
so
the
mystery guest, they've got it, but tell them who you are and what you did.
Okay, my name is John Mortar, and I created the campaign that successfully got Rage Against the Machine to the Christmas number one.
Yeah.
Were you a big Rage Against the Machine fan?
Yes, absolutely. One of the greatest bands ever.
Did you get to meet the band?
Yes, I did. Yeah, they actually reformed because of the
amazing
campaign.
Wow.
Yeah. Could you do the same thing with Blue? Serious question.
So, did you make anything out of that? Did they give you anything? Were they grateful?
Yeah, well, the money that they made from all the downloads, we did a campaign at the same time to raise money for Shelter. And they gave all the money to Shelter that they'd raised, and it's still bringing money in, £160,000. Wow. And we're still getting money in 5 years later.
Bloody mile, round of applause, that's terrific. Let's see how that's affected the scores. Jack and Claudia have 13 points. Ahead of them, Russell and Noel with 15. Jonathan and Warwick have 20. Time for another break, but ladies and gentlemen, one more time, John Mortar. Welcome back to the Big Fat Anniversary Quiz. This round's all about the sporting highlights of the last 10 years. Lewis Hamilton burst onto the Formula One scene in 2007. Top Gear's Jeremy Clarkson described him as a brilliant racing driver, which was a relief for all concerned. John Terry resigned from the England squad in 2012 so he could spend more time with his teammates' families. Team GB performed brilliantly at the Beijing Olympics. Some said we only won medals in minority sports, but I think the medals we won in badminton are just as legitimate as the ones we got in Kaplunk. You ready for questions?
Yes.
Of course you are. OK. Sky Sports legendary roving reporter Chris Kamara brought us many amazing moments, but what was particularly memorable about his coverage of a Portsmouth-Blackburn game on Saturday the 3rd, April 2010?
Have you met me?
Russell, do you remember this?
Yeah.
He's confident someone's going to tweet him. OK, so next question. The great thing about the London 2012 Olympics was how we all became overnight experts on minority sports, but in which discipline do you get judged on your wide behind, your purity and your schwung?
Don't be ridiculous.
Warwick has a question.
But that might give away the answer if I ask that question.
I'm pretty confident it was.
It might do. I asked if sumo was in the Olympics. What?
He's not in the Olympics, but it's only a question of time. OK, next up, it's over to one of Britain's favourite Paralympians. It's Ellie Simmons.
Yeah.
Hi, Jimmy. The London 2012 Olympic and Paralympic Games were absolutely amazing. And one of the hottest tickets at the Paralympics was for an event known as Murder Ball. But can your teams tell me what Murder Ball is?
OK, so Ellie Simmons wants to know what Murder Ball actually is.
That's when you haven't had for a while.
No, that's blue balls. Yes.
Blue ball.
Blue ball.
Blue ball.
Blue balls is a different thing, which Russell, I imagine, has never had.
Sorry?
The fly's back.
The fly's back. I caught him this time.
Ah! Oh, my God! Oh! Did you see?
10 points now.
10 points for fly catching.
Mr. Miyagi.
Pretty awesome. OK. What did Freddie Flintoff do that cost him his vice-captaincy of the England team during the 2007 Cricket World Cup?
How can we both catch a fly on one show and not get points?
I mean...
I gave you a point the first time.
Not one, that's about 1,000 points. What are the chances of me catching the same fly later on?
How do you know it was the same one?
Well, because he's called Chris.
One point is derisory for an achievement of that nature.
I mean, it's worth something. Not many quiz shows can boast fly catching.
Hold on, what's going on there? What gadget is being employed there?
What?
Popped up in the aid of question answering, there is an iPhone on public display.
Well, you just got that phone out, so if Chris comes back, we can get a selfie with him.
And finally, time for another Say What You See puzzle.
Oh, good.
OK, a massive sporting headline is hidden here. Yeah. What is it?
Ooh. Sporting headline.
I like the low-level murmur that comes.
We've got, yes, it's,
this a low-level murmur of, yeah, we're kind of watching, but we better work this out. Oh, it's good,
isn't
it?
That's got to be that bit.
That is right. That can't be anything but the first bit.
Joust. Oh, the murmur's getting... Oh, you quieting down with your murmuring. Think of it in your head. You don't need to say it out loud. OK, ready for some answers?
Yes.
OK, of course you are. OK. I asked you what was memorable about Chris Kamara's coverage of a Portsmouth-Blackburn match in 2010. What did you all put?
We put he sang Dancing on the Ceiling because he looks a bit like Lionel Richie.
Jonathan, Warwick, what did
you... We put he did it in Klingon because he looks a bit like Worf.
Both acceptable, in my opinion. Russell and Noel, you've got...
And we put he.
He. OK, that was, well, that's the beginning of something.
He didn't know the...
Someone had been sent off, he didn't know that.
He didn't know the score.
We've got
right answer, but I feel...
Well, there you go, then!
Score.
What's the nature of the quiz?
Well, let's have a look.
We're off to Fratton Park, where there's been a red card, but for who, Chris Kamara?
I don't know, Jeff, has it? I must have missed that. Red card?
Chris, have you not been watching? I haven't. I don't know where that's come from, Chris. I have no idea. What has happened there? What's happened, Chris?
I don't know, Jim.
Brilliant.
Chris Kamara, we salute you. Funny marvels. OK, I asked you in which discipline you get judged on your wide behind, your purity and your schwung.
And we put, every day of my life as an independent woman. Hashtag go sisters.
The weird thing is you wrote that, not Claudia.
I kept on going, is it archery? Is it... I don't know what it was.
No. Ladies, you with me?
Was it dressage?
Yeah. Yeah, it is, yeah.
But
you didn't write it. Yeah, it is, though, yeah.
Of course, I don't have to write it. It's in here.
Yeah, they kind of play that card. Can we have it once?
We've let Russell and Noel do it. Yeah, OK, you can have a point for that. Jonathan, what did you think it was?
Well, we wrote 100 metres twerking. And we're going to say out loud, dressage.
We can have that once.
Yeah, we can have one. Can we have that once?
So you're taking that bit.
Can you say 100 metres sparkling again?
You can have one later on if you get one.
That's a good sentence.
That's fine. OK, Russell, Noel?
Staggeringly enough, I didn't see this happen. I must have been talking to Chris. But there were, you wrote dresser harsh when I wasn't looking.
Sometimes I don't like to worry Noel with a quiz, because he's talking to Chris, he's got a lot on his mind. So I just get on with it, let him relax.
Noel seemed genuinely a little bit upset there that you got one right. Not right down when I wasn't looking, sorry. Dress on.
It was, no, it's like a little present. It was nice. I was thinking, it'd be nice if we got a dressage, and I looked down and we had. So I just thought, it's not the sort of thing we get right, but...
Here we are, having done so.
OK, well, OK, points to Russell and Noel, points to Jack and Claudia there. Ellie Simmons asked you what murder ball is. Jack and Claudia, you've got...
Oh, I'm sorry. I had a tiny sleep. It was... We thought it was...
We've been here a while. Why not? Go on.
Just a little miniature one. We thought it was water polo, but with sharks.
You got murder balls, water polo... Go on.
Yes, with sharks, and the ball is made of ham. Element of danger to what is otherwise just a jolly fun sport.
OK, that's not the right answer. Jonathan Warwick?
We either think it's wheelchair rugby or it's the name for the new lottery game.
OK, Russell, Noel?
It says wheelchair rugby there.
Like you've got nothing to do with that? Like that just...
Again, I was deep in conversation with Chris. I didn't even see that go down.
Well, it is wheelchair rugby. You both get points. Okay, I asked you how Freddie Flintoff lost his England vice captaincy in 2007. What did you put?
Well, you're all going to say pedalo, but it's incorrect, because that's just the thing that people use to get rid of him. It was actually bad field settings, failure to bring spin bowlers into the attack at crucial points, and not rotating the seamers when necessary. And you can say pedalo, but they were just waiting for that to happen so that they could stab him in the back. Fact. I can see we haven't got a lot of cricket fans in tonight. That's maybe the one crowd.
That is a hell of an answer.
Yeah.
10 points.
I will defend him.
Jonathan Warwick?
We put the correct answer, which is pedalo.
Pedalo, and you put... what is that scribble?
Oh, it's all getting a bit hieroglyphics-y down here. I don't know.
We were doing so well, we started to formulate a new language. But amidst it, you can say he got drunk, you can see that in there. Then we started to summon Chris. And it just says Chris. We called down Chris, but underneath there it says number 4, he got drunk, pedalo, it says there, pedalo.
OK, so you get a point for that, point for that. No point for the cricket regulations.
For the correct...
When we do Big Fat Cricket Quiz of the Year, then I think I'll be getting some points.
Yeah, and you'll be the only fucker here.
OK, yeah, he got drunk and he fell off a pedalo and he got the nickname Fredalo, which is adorable. OK, finally, I asked you to say what you saw. Did you get it? Jack, Claudia?
We went for Joust Fondle, Unitard, Bread Needles, Jo Malone Scented Candle.
Noel and Russell, what have you put?
Doping Lance Armstrong, as you can see, Lance, because there's a Lance, then an arm, then strong.
Yeah.
Doping Scandal.
Candle.
Apple. Scandal. So that's the correct answer.
Can I just say, we did write that, but this pen, the ink's run out in it, and we couldn't write the
it's
last...
It's electric.
Oh, yeah.
It's Lance Armstrong, Doe Pins Candle. You get a point. OK, all right. Oh, marvellous. Well, let's check in on the scores. Russell and Noel have 20 points. Jonathan and Warwick have 23. Jack and Claudia have 14 points. Yeah. Time for another break. Don't go away. Welcome back. This round is all about people, the movers and shakers of the last 10 years. Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes married in 2006 before divorcing in 2012. The story of Katie bravely breaking away from her husband to save her daughter is like something out of a movie you wouldn't bother watching because Katie Holmes is in it. Paul McCartney and Heather Mills split in 2006 when Paul said the words that Heather had dreaded hearing. Would you like to hear some of my new stuff? Paris Hilton came to the world's attention in 2004 with a sex tape famously shot in night vision. I didn't mind that, but I did find the whispering commentary from Chris Packham a bit off-putting. Ready for some more questions?
Yes.
Yeah, let's do this.
Here we go, the people of the last 10 years. Despite having a spectacular meltdown in 2011 and losing the highest paid job on television, Charlie Sheen retained a very positive outlook. He claimed to have tiger blood and Adonis DNA. But what upbeat mantra did he keep using throughout it all? So what was his mantra?
This is what we're doing.
What should we do?
What do you mean, what should we do?
What?
Do some bloody quizzing. Do some answering quiz questions.
We've done that one.
All right. Have a look at this. This is Chesley B. Sully Sullenberger, yes, who in 2009 was described as a miracle worker and a true American hero. What had he done to earn such a claim?
Oh, yeah. You
know, he's nice. What?
Sorry, what
did
that
he
name?
Do?
It was Chesley B. Sully Sullenberger.
Oh, great, thanks. Yeah.
Got it.
We got it.
It's a miracle
Chesley
worker.
Chesley B.
Sully Sullenberger.
Yeah, that's it, yes.
Sully Sullenberger.
No idea.
For our next question, it's over to my favourite hunk of the decade, Peter Andre, everyone.
Yes!
Jimmy, how are you? I can't believe it's been 10 years. Where does the time go? It truly is insane, yeah. In 2010, an unassuming New York estate agent, Anna Chapman, was propelled into the global spotlight because her remarkable secret was revealed. But what was that secret?
Right, can I say, major question, why the hell has he stolen Chico's hat?
Peter Andre wants to know how Anna Chapman sprung to international notoriety. Here she is. It's a pretty good answer.
Oh, yeah. She's a...
Okay, Christian Bale starred in Terminator Salvation in 2009, but what did he do on set that made the headlines?
Yeah. It's a terrible film.
Terminator Salvation?
Yes.
Yeah, because I know everything about films. If I say Terminator Salvation is a bad film, don't go and watch
when
it.
When I mentioned the word... when I gave my opinion, did I go like that in any state?
You do on the
side. Did I go like that in any state?
There's a certain air you give across, like a sort of arrogant peacock.
Finally, over to one of Britain's finest actors, Mr. Charles Dance, who's reading an extract from the autobiography of one of the biggest stars of the decade. But who is the mystery author? Over to you, Charles.
Chapter 3. Hip-hop tracks have traditionally been heavy on the beats, light on melody. But some MCs, Bone Thugs and Harmony, for example, find ways to work melodies into the rapping. Other MCs, think about Run from Run DMC, turn words into percussion. Cool Chief Rocker, I don't drink vodka, but keep a bag of Chiba inside my locker. The words themselves don't mean much, but he snaps those clipped syllables out like drum beats. Bap, 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 bap. If you listened to that joint and came away thinking it was a simple rhyme about holding weed in a gym locker, you'd be reading it wrong.
Do you like Charles Dance, Jonathan?
Yes, I like Charles Dance a lot. I think he's bloody good in films.
Warwick, I imagine you've worked with Charles Dance, I imagine you have, haven't you?
No, I haven't, no. Never. No. No, he's not the good fortune to work with me.
Okay. No. What, are you ready for some answers?
Yes.
Of course you are, okay. I asked you what Charlie Sheen's upbeat mantra was. What did you put?
Winning.
Yeah, we put that.
Yep. I tell you, that is the right answer. Do you know Charlie Sheen? Have you met Charlie Sheen?
As a matter of fact, I do know Charlie Sheen. And during that explosive period, I went round his house and gave him some advice to give you some idea of how serious it was. I said, Charlie, you need to start making some changes. Although we're all enjoying the catchphrases, it looks to me like you'll be dead within the hour.
OK, so points for everyone. OK. I asked you what Chesley B. Sully Sullenberger did in 2009 to earn such a claim. What did you all put?
Take it away, Claude.
Brought James Blunt to the USA.
He did not, but he could have. He could have.
That would have done.
Jonathan, Warwick?
Warwick got this. I didn't have any idea.
Landed a plane on the Hudson.
Oh!
That is the right answer. What did you guys get?
Is that commendable?
I put turned into a shoe. Russell put landed a plane on the Hudson.
Landed a plane on the Hudson is the right answer.
I remember the footage. It was incredibly... It was heroic. Yeah.
And he was very kind of... He was very cool about it as well.
What I love as well is that it was America, so you knew that they'd all be applauding. If that was Britain, everyone on the plane would just be like, well, we're going to be late now, aren't we?
Peter Andre asked you how New York estate agent Anna Chapman sprung to international notoriety. Russell, Noel, let's go to you first.
Well, I have to write the correct answers over things that Noel puts, like showed her bum bum to God.
Did she show her bum bum to God?
It was a real low point in the quiz for me. A kind of mini breakdown.
I put the correct answer just above it, just to keep us in it. Spy. She is a spy.
OK, thanks for talking through the... your emotional process. OK, Jonathan Warwick, what did you get?
She was a Russian spy, and I think when she went home to Russia, didn't Putin give her a tiger or something? He gave her a tiger or a panther or a leopard.
Really?
As a pet. Yes, he gave her
that's correct.
Magnificent
Putin gave her
a
python or a leopard.
It wasn't
or...
a python. How is a python like a leopard?
Hedgehog.
You got any legs?
You are literally doing it there. Come on.
I am doing it.
Yes,
I am. You're there. I did it once.
Oh, you got him.
I did it once. I got angry. He didn't give a python. He gave her a bloody tiger.
Did you get this, Jack?
Yes. Spy. She's a spy.
She was a Russian spy out of a Bond film. Look at that. Incredible. I asked you what Christian Bale did while filming Terminator Salvation. What did you put?
Somebody was in his eye line. They were in the light. I think it was the first AD or something like that, and he shouted. He went, he lost...
Yeah. He didn't do his normal acting, shouting at someone that he shouldn't have been shouting at.
He didn't go, hey.
He didn't do, where is she?
That is a terrifyingly good Batman. Ooh,
yeah. Haven't practiced that before. I don't have to do that one.
Pretty good. Pretty bloody good.
Young Jack Whitehall in the new Batman film delivers a very convincing performance.
Russell, Noel, what have you got?
We push out at crew.
And then...
then Noel took over the pen for a while.
He did a Mel Gibson. He went nuts. Someone I know was working as an extra. You know the last Batman film with Bane, which was not very good? Not very good. And there was the big thing down in Wall Street. And someone that was an extra on that, and he's also from Wales, which is where Christian Bale, I believe, is from originally.
Yeah.
And he went up to him, and he's, like, in character as Batman. And do you like it when actors stay in character, or do you think it's a bit dicky?
It's pretentious, yeah.
It's a bit pretentious. So he went up to him, and he went, all right, Christian, I'm... This is a Welsh accent. I'm from Wales, too. Whereabouts in Wales are you from? He went, I'm from Gotham. Well, no, I know Batman, but where are you from? He went, Gotham. And we're Gotham.
OK, well, let's treat ourselves to a listen at a Welsh man going nuts on a film set.
Oh, da-da-da-da, like this in the background. What the fuck is it with you? Oh, good for you. And how was it? I hope it was fucking good because it's useless now, isn't it? No, shut the fuck up, Bruce. Fuck's sake, man, you're amateur. I want to fucking kick your fucking ass. You know, shut up for a second, all right? Fucking ass.
Say shut the fuck up, Bruce. That's Bruce Wayne. He's so... he can't get out of character.
All right, so everyone gets a point for that. OK, finally, Charles Dance read from an autobiography, one of the biggest stars of the decade. Who was it? What do you all get?
We thought it was from Claire Balding's... which was very popular. It's very popular, wasn't it? And we both enjoyed it. And she does like the beach. She loves the dirty grime. She likes the jungle, the garage. She loves the garage.
Russell, Noel, what have you gone for?
Common.
One of the biggest stars of the decade.
You bastards.
Someone texted you a message just saying common, and you went, well, that will...
What else could that have fucking meant?
Jack, Claudia, what have you got?
Jay-Z or the boy called Dappy.
OK, well, let's go back to Charles Dance.
That was taken from the memoirs of Jay-Z.
Jay-Z, OK, so points for Claudia and Jack on that. Yeah. So we've got a very special treat for you now. It's Mr. Louis Spence!
You loved it.
Having a hot flush. Okay. So you came to fame in the last 10 years, Pineapple Studios.
Yeah.
You're a huge star.
Yeah.
So what are you up to these days? What are you doing?
Pantomime. I'm that huge.
Now, you're going to do some interpretive dance. You're doing what you do best. Yeah. OK, so this is going to be one of the big news stories of the last 10 years. Oh. Louis is going to dance that story.
This is amazing.
And you're going to write down what news story he is.
I'm going to cry. Okay.
This is going to be beautiful.
It's amazing.
Louis. Oh, he's still got it. Emotionally draining, but beautiful. So that was one of the big news stories of the last decade. Write down the answer, come on. There was horses, he consumed, he fell ill.
That was that.
He cooked.
You are amazing.
In the dark.
He's incredible.
You should know that. You are an amazing man.
Oh, that's a great dancer. You have a great dance. Well, let's see what everyone got. Russell, Noel, you got something?
Yeah.
Well, okay. What have you got?
Horse burgers.
Horse burgers, OK. Jonathan, Warwick?
Warwick got this horse meat in lasagna, etc., the kind of horse meat scandal.
OK, Jack, Claudia?
Horse meat scandal.
Tell them what you were dancing.
I was doing the horse meat scandal.
Yes.
A round of applause. Let's see how that affected the scores. Russell and Noel have 25 points. Jonathan and Warwick are just in the lead with 28. Jack and Claudia bringing up the rear with 19 points. We're going to take a short break while I put back to sleep the thing that Louis has awakened in me. See you in a bit. Welcome back to the final part of the Big Fat Anniversary Quiz. This round's all about the talking points and water cooler moments of the last 10 years. Zumba was one of the dance exercise crazes of the decade. The great thing about Zumba is... No, I got nothing. Celebrity perfumes became all the rage. David Beckham had Instinct, Britney Spears, Curious, Cheryl Cole, Stormflower, and, of course, my fragrance. I'd give that 5 minutes if I were you. The fox hunting ban came into force in 2004. The fox hunting ban came into force in 2004. Personally, I found it difficult to sympathise with them. After all, they're just small-minded, inbred creatures that don't actually do anything. And to make matters worse, they love hunting foxes.
That was the worst throw ever.
Well, let's have a look at the final lot of questions.
Yes.
Mm. OK. Which piece of advice, first coined by the Ministry of Information in 1939, unexpectedly became one of the most popular slogans of the last 10 years? OK. Charity wristbands became a great way to show your support for a cause you love. Yellow wristbands represented Lance Armstrong's Live Strong charity. Blue symbolised your support for anti-bullying charities. But what did a white wristband mean?
I know.
So, charity wristbands...
so bad! I want my own screen.
We have to have a bit of fun.
You have to have a bit of fun,
we're playing against these two who have cheated because they know so much about movies, and basically the whole thing has been about movies. Those two who have cheated for the entire game by, like, blatantly texting members of the audience. They will probably then reward with sexual favours and covering glitter.
Are you texting?
You haven't even tried to hide it.
We've participated in good faith in this quiz.
What? It's bullshit.
What's happening?
You've clearly been... Whoa!
It's literally there.
Right, this is a...
World of Warcraft. why would you have World of Warcraft written?
What the...
Raise money for cancer.
See, we're trying to help people with cancer. And you have the...
Gore. Cork.
But look, all right. No. I can sit down.
No. Sit back down, Che Guevara.
I'm
answered.
Have you answered? Hello?
You little shit!
That lad is an angel!
Defend him!
Have you been trying to help Russell Knowles?
He's made a mockery of the entire evening.
Actually, they were working in consortium and they were all very helpful. They were sort of communicating among one another. And isn't it better to see people working together as a real team rather than stupid quiz that don't even mean nothing anyway?
This is anarchy.
You cannot
have this.
This is anarchy, Jimmy.
No,
this is not anarchy.
That.
This is bullshit.
It's like the end of Avatar. Flies were helping us, people helping us. It's justice.
Well, OK, clearly, not only have you been cheating, but you've got a lot of the answers wrong.
I think it's very appropriate that we're looking at a Lance Armstrong wristband throughout the whole of this.
OK. Have a look at these three pictures. What did each of these drivers blame for their mishap?
Jim?
Yeah?
Cover my phone back.
No.
All right, so, that makes
us the baby. So what's this?
Someone has just texted you to say Chris Tarrant would let you ask the audience.
That's good, yeah.
They're quite a lovely bunch.
I got that's good, I like that. Yeah, you've won me back. You've won me back.
And for our next question, it's over to Abby Clancy.
Hi, Jimmy. In November 2005, British Airways sent a memo out to cabin staff forbidding them from indulging in which naughties fad during takeoff and landing.
OK.
BA staff had to stop doing something.
Yeah, for takeoff and landing.
Got it.
For takeoff and landing?
Takeoff and landing, they couldn't do something. Final question. What caused a surge in demand for the Gara roofer fish in 2010?
I actually know that.
We know this.
Yeah. You don't want us to get it.
Oh,
get it.
Was it the great John Dory drought? Yeah.
Ready for some answers?
Yeah. Let's go for it.
Of course you are. Okay. I asked you which phrase, coined by the Ministry of Information, became one of the most popular slogans of the last 10 years. What did you put?
YOLO.
You think YOLO was coined in...
No, I don't, but I'm with somebody
obviously, obviously not as YOLO. It was you only live once, which is what YOLO stands for. So,
why would they give out that information? Why would the government give out information, you only live once? To encourage the kind of anarchy we've seen over here.
No, I'm not sure how, or Button Man, how you speak, but what did you put for this?
Is this the, keep calm and carry on, which is what he's doing, as a matter of fact.
OK, Jonathan, what?
We first of all, we thought Vorsprung durch Technik, but then we settled on keep calm and carry on,
Keep calm and carry on is the right answer.
Yeah.
I asked you what white charity wristband symbolised. Did anyone remember?
No, you said you didn't say charity, you said a white wristband, and I said escape from a ward.
Yeah, but I actually know what it is.
So, which is true. You should have been more specific.
Jonathan, Warwick?
We thought it was a UKIP membership. We thought that's what they wore.
It's a purple and yellow wristband, Dick. Not that I know.
It's Make Poverty History.
Make Poverty History is the right answer. Russell, Noel?
Well, this is at the juncture at which you severed our tie to the common mind. So we've just, you know, we've put cancer.
You just wrote cancer as an answer.
That's the rest of our answers. It's cancer. Well, you know, because you broke us.
Yeah, it's a popular TV quiz. Maybe one of the answers is cancer. Yeah. Sure, maybe.
What about when that fucking geezer was dancing around as horse meat? Nothing makes sense.
You make a very good point. OK. I asked you what was to blame for those motoring mishaps. Did you get this?
Oh, I feel bad now.
Yeah,
he's coming
I'm
in a flurry, listening to Jonathan Ross's radio show. But that, no! Wouldn't it seem so harsh if I hadn't just been mean there?
Because it's so brilliant!
You've just had a text in, by the way, saying make poverty history. Too little, too late, mate. I fear. OK, did you...
Yes, we did. We looked at the pictures, we thought it might be climate change. Mm-hmm. But then Warwick said he thinks it's satellite navigation system.
Oh, bollocks, yeah.
I'm guessing you didn't get this one, then.
Yeah, OK.
I'm all right, mate. We've got each other, ain't we? We've got your sparkly costume, we've got that helmet thing. We used to have Chris. He's
Jimmy, gone. The puppet man, has tried to break us, but he never will.
Never break us. 10 quizzes.
We've got each other.
If anything, I've just made you stronger. OK.
You're a quiet
loner. That is the right answer. What, are you making?
Yeah, these are new wristbands. They're called Make Cheating History.
Yeah. We'll sign up for those.
OK. Abby Clancy asked you what British Airways staff were forbidden from doing during takeoff and landing. What did you put?
Losing our bags.
not the right answer. Jonathan Warwick?
We were torn between either the ice bucket challenge, which would be a bad idea...
during takeoff, you thought that we'd do the ice bucket.
You'd be a very bad idea during takeoff and landing. Or maybe Angry Birds.
Angry Birds.
Angry Birds.
Angry Birds you're closer with, but it's not right. Oh. Did you get this, Russell? Noel?
You know we didn't.
Noel, are you actually asleep? I can tell you, no one got this. Playing Sudoku. I asked you why there was a surge in demand for the Garro roofer fish in 2010. What have you got?
Feet pedicure fish thing.
Yes.
That is the right answer. Yeah. Jonathan Warwick, did you get this?
Eating the skin on the feet.
OK, so, Russell, Noel actually got that right. Well done, then.
Well, they were able to mime it quite well.
Let's have a check-in on the scores, OK? So, Jack and Claudia have 20 points.
Oh, okay.
Russell and Noel have 27. Jonathan and Warwick have 31.
Yeah. Well, you're not even in that.
Yeah, and he might have a big bonus check-in. That's the problem.
It is still all to play for.
Sorry, how?
I'll tell you how, because we have the final big, fat anniversary quiz question. And to ask it all the way from the planet Skaro, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a Dalek. Welcome to the show. It's an honour to have you here.
Be silent or you will be exterminated.
All right. You've got a question, I believe.
Yes. Show me the question immediately.
There you go.
My vision is impaired. I cannot see correctly.
There?
Better. Focusing. I require 3 pieces of data from the last 10 Earth years. The biggest selling album. The highest grossing movie. The best selling app. The humans over there will now answer. Answer or be exterminated.
Chill out.
So he's looking for the best-selling album, the highest-grossing film, and the best-selling app. These are all in the UK.
In the UK.
Correct. That's key to this.
Okay. Is this a male Dalek or a female Dalek?
It's hard to tell. I don't know where to look.
Excuse me, are you a male Dalek or a female Dalek?
There is no such thing as gender in the Dalek world.
Right, good.
Don't matter that much in the human world.
You should work more outside of Doctor Who. Have you had any offers?
Many.
Yeah, he's on 8 out of 10 cats next week. It's going to be huge, yeah.
I will exterminate all the cats!
OK, everyone's got answers. So, Russell, Noel, what have you got?
We think it's Blunt, Angry Birds,
Avatar. I thought it was Gaga, but he's...
OK, I can tell you that you got one of those right. Jack, Claudia?
James Blunt, Back to Bedlam, obviously. That's the one they got right. Avatar, or as we call it, Blue the Movie. One day. And Angry Birds.
OK, you got one right.
Yep.
What?
James Blunt.
Yeah. Jonathan, Warwick, what have you got?
Well, we got Angry Birds as well.
Yeah.
We thought, because it's UK, we thought Skyfall was the biggest movie, and then we thought it would be one of the Adele albums, but we couldn't remember what number, because there's like 17, 18, I don't know if she's done 21 yet, actually.
OK, let's go back to the Dalek to find out. What were the correct answers? What were you looking for?
The best-selling album was 21 by Adele.
You even got the year. Come on.
The highest-grossing film was Skyfall.
Come on.
Now you must all surrender to the Daleks. Surrender or be exterminated.
Well, hang on a second. We'll do the final scores just before anyone surrenders. So the final scores are. Let's see what that's done. I could take in last place. Jack and Claudia with 22. The cheats with 29, Russell and Noel, are well done. But the winners of the Big Fat Anniversary Quiz, Jonathan and Warwick, with 39 points.
Thank you.
Again, thank you. Well done. Silence. Silence. Exterminate.